Hello and greetings. Today, once again, we have Ugly Duckling back on the table. You might be getting tired of seeing this truck, but we still have a lot to do to this truck. Today, though, isn't so much an upgrade as a repair. Last time out on the rocks, we had an accident happen to Ugly Duckling, and the body cracked. So today, we're going to go over how to fix the body. Let me show you where the body cracked at. Right here. Little crack running right through the corner right there. How did that happen? Well, if you notice, the honcho bed right here does not set down fully on the frame rail. And the truck took a tumble and it let the bed push down, flexed the body, and pulled it apart right here. You see it gapping. So what we're going to do is we're going to fix the body. And to keep this from happening again, if you have a honcho bed, you might want to do this yourself, is right here, we're going to build up some plasticard. And then that way the tubes on the bottom of the honcho bed will set down tight against that and won't have room to flex. So that way it won't be flexing the body and won't end up cracking it. Here's another angle on the crack. You might be able to see it a little bit better here on the inside corner of this. Right there. So how are we going to fix this crack? Well, we're going to use shoe goo. A lot of people use shoe goo to fix the cracks in bodies. And we're going to do it here, but we're going to do something a little extra than just shoe goo. We're also going to use this mat right here. This is called Silver Standard Cross Stitch Fabric. It's a mesh-like fabric that we are going to push into the shoe goo to add extra strength to the repair. Now, to do this repair, first thing you want to do is make sure the area that you're going to repair is clean. I took a damp cloth, wiped out the dirt from this area, and made sure it was nice and dry. This is where you can see it just a little bit better. There we go. The next thing you want to do is take your cloth here and cut a section of it about the size of the brake, just a little bit bigger there. So we're going to go ahead and do that. See, I cut me a piece about like so, and that will set right in here. Now, something you might want to do, though, is remove this screw right here. Otherwise, you may get shoe goo all over it and could cause problems later on. And now we're ready now that we have that screw out, we are ready to fix the crack. I have my piece ready here to put in. Something you might want to use is a rubber glove. This will let you push the shoe goo into the fabric a little bit better, kind of impregnate the fabric. So put my glove on. Now we're going to open our shoe goo. Take a little bit of shoe goo here. We'll put it on our finger, our gloved finger. And we're going to smear this down through where the crack is. Like so. Make sure you get the entire crack. You may have to use more than one glob of it. There we go. Now I'm going to take my cloth piece here and I'm going to push it into the goo. Now I'm going to put more goo over top of that to help seal it into place. And you're taking your finger and pushing on the cloth, which is pushing the goo down through it. It's kind of impregnating it. Pushing all the way through. What this will do, this will kind of help add a reinforcement so that hopefully we don't have no more problem here. And hopefully this will stop the crack from becoming worse in the future. Now, once you finish on the inside, make sure you flip the body over, because see the crack right here? Some came out through the crack. And you're going to want to rub that off. Like so. Now, if you get any excess on the outside of the body, that's fine. A little bit of alcohol on a paper towel will take it right off. May take a little bit of scrubbing, but a little bit of alcohol, and it'll start to come right off, see? Let's continue cleaning that up while the inside dries. Now it may take just a little bit of scrubbing to get this off, but it'll come off just fairly easy with a little bit of alcohol, a little bit of elbow grease. And then you won't even know that it was ever on the outside of the body. A good thing about shoe goo is it does dry fairly quickly. And here we have that raised section I made out of plastic card. It's still white right here, but I've completely made this piece that will hold up the bottom of the honcho bed. So hopefully we never have this problem again. I will take this and spray paint it black. That way nobody will ever see it. And here we see the completed repair. Have the shoe goo and the cloth impregnated with it. Hopefully we will have no more problems out of this. On the outside, you can't even tell that it was ever cracked. It's got a light line right there. Now what we're going to do is we're going to go ahead and put our screw back in right here, and then we'll put the body back on the truck. And here we have the completed project. The only thing left for us to do is to paint this brace that I put underneath here and put some screws in to hold it in place. As you can tell now, the body does not flex. The bed can't push down and flex the body through here in a hard rollover crash. So we should be good to go. The bodies of our trucks and cars, they take a beating out there. They get cracked, they get broke, they get tears in them, so it's nice to know how to fix them. This is a nice, easy, cheap way to do this. This will end up costing about $6 for all the materials that I used today, and these materials will go a long way. You'll have enough to fix probably 100 cracks. So I hope you've enjoyed this video. If you have any questions or comments, drop them down below. Make sure you subscribe so you don't miss any of our future videos, quick tips, any of our how-tos, updates to any of our other projects, or any new projects coming. So, you can also follow us on Instagram or Facebook. We do post a lot on Instagram, so I suggest you check it out. And until next time, happy RCing!